That sounds like the world's greatest punk cover band of all time, Me First and the Gimme Gimmes. So it must be M Day here at ABC 123. I am also wearing my Mandalorian shirt. Mandalorian. Am I right? So let's get started, shall we? Up first is John McCutcheon, my favorite folk singer of all time. I've been listening to this guy since I was a kid. He has released over 40 albums during my lifetime. I have 18 of them, including his latest from a few months ago called Cabin Fever, which he recorded during the early months of the quarantine. He is one of the greats, right up there with Woody Guthrie and Pete Seeger as far as I'm concerned. The album I've chose to sample for you today is his first greatest hits collection. This is called Water from Another Time. This came out in 1989. It gathered his best material from the 70s and 80s. Highlights for me include The Great Storm Is Over, Kindergarten Wall, and this masterclass in storytelling, Christmas in the Trenches. This is the true story of the holiday ceasefire of World War I, when both sides heard each other singing Christmas songs and bravely met in the middle to celebrate together despite being enemies on the battlefield. Here's a clip of what happened right after that.
Soon daylight stole upon us, and France was France once more. With sad farewells we each began to settle back to war. But the question haunted every heart that lived that wondrous night. Whose family have I fixed within my sights? It was Christmas in the trenches, where the frost so bitter hung. The frozen fields of France were warmed as songs of peace were sung. For the walls they'd kept between us to exact the work of war had been crumbled and were gone forevermore.
Sorry, I can't do my trademark dancing to that one, but it is a super powerful song, and I hope you go and check out the whole thing if you haven't heard it before. Up next is one of my favorite discoveries of the last 10 years or so, a group by the name of the Milk Carton Kids. Now, the name makes them sound like they're maybe like an emo rock group or something, but it's far from that. Picture more of like the gentlest moments of Simon and Garfunkel. It's two guys and their guitars making beautiful music. My favorite album came before this one. It's called The Ash and Clay. I only have that digitally, though, and this is CDs. So this is the follow-up, Monterey, from 2015. This is the opening track, Asheville Skies.
But I cannot remember that fleeting hopeful song, that rose of our September, my word, what have we done? I love nothing more than to cover my face, forget who
I hope M Day is not putting you to sleep, but these are beautiful songs that I have to share with you. Finally, here is a disc from a great songwriter, Chris Mills. This is his 2014 album, Alexandria, where he went by Chris Mills and the Distant Stars. My friend Ben Vogt had introduced me to his song several years before this. I love everything he has put out, but the big story that goes along with this selection is that he performed in my living room. Yes, we hosted a Chris Mills concert in our home. If you're not familiar with living room tours, it is a great way for artists to have a more intimate experience with their fans, and it was certainly that. There were probably only about 30 of us gathered that night. It was a music lover's dream come true. It's something I'll be talking about until the day I die. So here's a song from the album called Wild Places. It's a gentle day here at ABC 123, but I hope you've enjoyed it. That's it. Stay tuned for N coming up soon. And in the meantime, check out the links below for the full versions of all these songs.